So cross passages are small connecting tunnels between the two primary tunnels. They're used for emergency evacuation purposes. They're located approximately every 220 metres. Cross passages are constructed after the TBMs have constructed the primary tunnel and the segmental lining is installed. So before we start the excavation of cross passage, there are some preliminary works that are really critical to the whole operation. Between Arden and the new side of the Kensington entrance, we had to do quite extensive ground improvement from the surface. That's a whole separate process in itself, where a separate site is established on the surface and we do various ground improvement techniques. So one of those is called jet grouting, where we use a rig and we essentially replace the soil and strengthen it. And that's done over a course of several months. And once that process is being completed, we then let it cure and then we start the excavation process from underground. So after the completion of the tunnel drives between Arden and the new side of the Kensington entrance, four cross passages have been slowly excavated. The process of constructing a cross passage depends on a number of factors. So the location, depth, the geology. We need to create an opening through the segmental lining. Now the segmental lining as a symmetrical structure is quite strong, but once you put an opening through it, you have to reinforce that opening. So the first step is to put in temporary supporting beams. They're bolted to the segmental lining to give it that extra strength. Once that's been established, we then cut an opening in the segmental lining and then we start the excavation process. The excavation process itself is more of a traditional mining or tunneling process where we have an excavator that's used to remove the material in small advances and then we shotcrete that advance. Depending on the ground conditions, and we also install rock bolts or lattice girders or other forms of reinforcement. So we repeat that process in small advances that typically consist about 1.5 to 2 metres. Once we get to the other side of the cross passage, there's a small little breakthrough for the crew, and that's quite a milestone for those crews as well. I mean, they're not easy jobs. Traditional mining is something that's a little bit more hands-on. We then go into the process of installing the waterproofing, which is a membrane. We obviously seal off all sources of groundwater. Once we install the membrane for waterproofing each cross passage, the permanent lining is installed. Now that's done in several stages. The first stage is to cast the invert or the floor of the cross passage. We then construct the obvert, which is the top half of the cross passage. And then we do the collars, which is the intersecting point between the main lining of each cross passage and the segmental lining. So now that Joan and Meg have passed through the area between Arden and Parkville, the cross passage team have now started excavating those cross passages, and they'll do that progressively all the way to CBD South.